the forgotten dwarf planet, Ceres. Definition of Ceres. Is Pluto the only dwarf in our solar system? Deep in the space hidden from our eyes lies a planet whose surface temperature reaches a whopping maximum of 180 Kelvin and as low as 240 Kelvin. Yes, we are talking about the Forgotten Dwarf, the largest object in the asteroid belt lying between Mars and Jupiter. Named after the Roman goddess of agriculture and discovered in 1801 by the Italian astronomer Giuseppe Piazzi, Ceres is a perfectly spherical body despite being bombarded by thousands of tiny asteroids daily. It has been in discussion among scientists recently, as many believe Ceres is our best occupancy option. Ceres is believed to be the least geologically active body in the solar system, with no evidence of volcanism, tectonic activity, or significant erosion. It has a low density and a low gravitational field, and its surface is covered in impact craters, suggesting that it has been relatively inactive for billions of years. Overview of Ceres. Dwarf planet is a designation given to celestial bodies that are too small to be considered full-sized planets, but have enough mass and gravity to be nearly round. Being the most massive object in the asteroid belt, it is also the first object in the asteroid belt to be classified as a dwarf planet. Ceres is the only dwarf planet in the inner solar system. Its surface is covered in impact craters, with some smooth areas that may have been caused due to cryovolcanism. Due to constant volcanic activities on the planet, the surface appears shiny and dark when observed through telescopes. Ceres was formed 4.6 billion years ago, shortly after the formation of the solar system. It is believed that it formed from the same material that came together to form the other planets, moons, and asteroids in the region. The formation of Ceres was likely aided by the gravitational pull of Jupiter and Saturn, which caused the material in the asteroid belt to coalesce and form into the objects that exist today. Size and mass. One of the striking features of Ceres is its colossal size compared to other objects in the belt. At 590 miles in diameter, it is the largest object in the asteroid belt and roughly the same size as the state of Texas. Ceres is also much denser than most asteroids, with a mass of about 9 quintillion tons, about a third of the entire asteroid belt's mass. Ceres is not a solid rocky planet like Earth or Mars, despite its size and density. Instead, it is believed to be composed mainly of water ice, with a rocky core and a thin, dusty mantle. It is because Ceres has a surface temperature of about 180 Kelvin, which is too cold for liquid water to exist. The water on Ceres is considered frozen solid, making it a water world in the same sense as Europa and Enceladus, two of Jupiter's moons that are also considered to have large amounts of water ice beneath their surfaces. Surface features of Ceres. In 2015, NASA's Dawn spacecraft arrived at Ceres and began studying the dwarf planet in detail. The spacecraft found that the dwarf planet has two distinct types of terrain, one that is heavily cratered and one that is relatively smooth. The smooth terrain is thought to be the result of recent geological activity, possibly due to the presence of a subsurface ocean. The spacecraft also found that Ceres has a surprisingly diverse surface, with various geological features such as mountains, craters, and plains. One of the most fascinating features of Ceres is a series of bright, reflective spots discovered on its surface. These spots, which were thought to be salt deposits, are concentrated in a region called Ocator Crater, which is about 60 miles wide. Scientists believe that the bright spot may be the result of saline water that was spewed out by a meteor impact and that the water froze and left behind the salt deposits. Ceres is also home to some of the fascinating geological structures found in the solar system. One, the Ocator Crater, is a massive impact crater located near the center of Ceres, measuring about 90 kilometers in diameter. 2. Ahuna Mons. Ceres is also home to one of the largest mountains in our solar system relative to its size. This mountain, called Ahuna Mons, is about 13,000 feet or 4,000 meters tall, and is thought to be a cryovolcano or a volcano that erupts with water, ammonia, or other volatile substances rather than molten rock. Due to a large number of water resources on Ceres, it has always been a topic of discussion among scientists. Some scientists even believe that Ceres may be the perfect resource storage for us to be used in the future during interstellar travel. Indeed, owing to the large reserves of water present on this planet, which may be mined in the near future. Ceres has been studied extensively over the past few decades, and scientists have learned a great deal about its characteristics, composition, and geological history. Internal structure. Ceres has a differentiated internal structure consisting of a silicate-rich crust, a mantle of ice and volatile compounds, and a core composed of a mixture of rocky materials and ice. The crust is estimated to be around 30 to 40 kilometers thick, while the mantle is believed to be at least several hundred miles wide. The core is thought to be roughly 200 kilometers in diameter and may contain up to 30% of ice by mass. Some scientists believe that Ceres may contain clues about the early solar system, as Ceres and other objects in the asteroid belt are the remnants of the solar system's building blocks. Surface composition. The surface of Ceres consists primarily of a mixture of water ice, silicate rock, and organic compounds. The exact composition of Ceres' surface varies across its surface, with some regions having a higher percentage of the water ice component. In comparison, others may have a higher rate of the silicate rock component. The organic compounds are mainly associated with a variety of craters, suggesting that they were delivered to the surface through asteroid impacts. The surface of Ceres is also believed to contain a variety of salts and other volatile materials, including carbonates, sulfates, and nitrogen-bearing compounds. These materials are thought to have been delivered to the surface over time by comet and asteroid impacts. The Dawn spacecraft played a vital role in the determination of geological conditions on Ceres. Had it not been launched, you wouldn't be watching this video. The spacecraft conducted a detailed study of Ceres and its environment, allowing scientists to understand better the dwarf planet's geology, composition, and history. The Dawn mission revealed Ceres' weak atmosphere, primarily water vapor. In addition, Dawn was the one to find evidence of ice on the surface of Ceres, suggesting that the dwarf planet may contain a subsurface ocean of liquid water. Recent observations from the Herschel Space Observatory have confirmed this possibility. The Dawn mission also allowed scientists to map the surface of Ceres in detail. In addition to the Dawn mission, other spacecraft have visited the dwarf planet. In 2018, the European Space Agency's Rosetta mission conducted a flyby of Ceres, allowing scientists to make detailed observations of the dwarf planet's surface. Ceres continues to be one of the fascinating objects in the solar system, and scientists are sure to learn more as new missions are launched to study it. Ceres is an intriguing and fascinating body, and is the only dwarf planet in the inner solar system. Its unique characteristics and geological history make it an important target for further study. With the help of spacecraft like Dawn, we can continue to learn more about this mysterious world. Despite this, its exact origin and history are still largely unknown. Efforts are being made as we speak to have a complete overlook on Ceres. It may not be a while, but soon we may have significant knowledge about Ceres to specify its significance to humans. Overall, Ceres is an essential object in the solar system due to its size and composition. Its existence has helped to shape our understanding of the solar system and its formation.